Assalamu alaikum. Subject Science, Grade 5, Chapter Number 7, Weather Patterns, Lesson Number 1, The Atmosphere and Weather, Page Number 368. Vocabulary: What are global winds, trade winds, Coriolis effect? So let's see one by one all of them. First, what are global winds? My dear students, hundreds of years ago, sailing ships carried trade goods around the world. When sailing from Europe to the Americas, the captains wanted to travel from northeast to north southwest. They found that winds blow in this direction between the equator and 30 degree N latitude. So you can see here the direction and from where the 30 degree is making here and in this way. Now, what are global winds? Latitude is a measurement of how far north or south a place is from the equator. If you can see here the equator, so you can easily find out where the latitude, the measurement. Winds that blow between about 30 degree N latitude and about 30 degree S latitude became known as trade wind. So what are the trade winds that blow from 30 degree S and 30 degree N? Global winds. Trade winds are part of a system of winds called global winds. A global wind blows steadily over long distance in a predictable direction. Global winds blow because sunlight heats areas near Earth's equators more than it heated areas near Earth's pole. So here the area that is near the equator, it becomes more heat than the as compared to the area near the Earth's pole. Coriolis effect. As Earth rotates, places near the poles travel a shorter distance than places near the equator. This causes winds away from the equator to curve. In the northern hemisphere, winds curve to the right or clockwise. So you can see here one is the clockwise and second the anticlockwise. In the southern hemisphere, winds cover the left or counterclockwise, or you can say that anticlockwise or counterclockwise. The Coriolis effect describes the change in the direction of something on or above, up and down Earth's surface because of Earth's rotation. The Coriolis effect causes these winds to curve. Instead of moving straight, it moves, or you can say that force the wind to move in a curved path. If the Coriolis effect was the only factor in the movement of winds from the north pole to the equator, you might predict that all the global winds would blow in the same direction. However, between latitude 30N and 60N, the global winds don't blow in the predicted direction. So a Coriolis effect has a impact on equator, on the ocean current and wind direction. So you can see that in this way they change the direction of the wind. What causes these global winds to change direction? If you count the number of particles in cold air and compare it to the number of particles in the same amount of warm air. When you're going to count the number of particles in hot and cold air, the cold air will have more particles in it. The cold air is more denser, mean to say more heavier, because the particles are present in the colder one is more, or packed with particles, and due to the presence of lot of particles in it, than the warm air as compared to the warm air. Cold air sinks and warm air rise. Why? Because due to more number of particle in cold air, it become denser and will, you can say that go down as compared to the warm. It's the number of particle less in warm air, and it will be go up. So you can see here this the cold pole and this also cold, but here it's the warm. As air is heated at the equator, it rises up within the troposphere. As the air goes higher, the temperature decreases and the air begins to cool. Because heated air continues to rise, the colder air above it is pushed away from the equator to the north. You might think that the cooling air would flow all the way to the North Pole. Actually, air warms and cools in three different bands. You can see there 1, 2, and 3 bands. As it moves north from the equator, in the middle band, the direction of the cooling air is reversed and the winds blow in the opposite direction. All here it's showing the direction and the bands of the